It was nice to see the HBO intro again. Hello guys, I'm Nona Prince and today we're talking about the latest English TV show called Mayor of Easttown. Created and written by Brad Ingoldsby, directed by Craig Zobel. Producer and leading from front is the wonderful Kate Winslet. The show is available to watch on Disney Plus Hotstar Premium. No spoilers until I say it. But if you want to go into the series blank without knowing anything, then stop the video, go watch, then come back. The first thing I felt was how the world of this TV show is so compelling. We see a lot of characters throughout this town, and it's not just about one character. In that sense, it reminds me of Dark or Stranger Things, where there are multiple characters throughout the town and we know all of them, and you know, all their stories are interlinked. Of course, the wonderful Kate Winslet, she was the big drawing point for me to watch the series. Now, this show is a murder mystery mixed with family drama, and I like that mix really well, because mostly from a murder mystery, you expect it to be very serious, very dark, very gritty. But this show is all of that, but still has family drama and some comedy to it. There are a lot of moments where it gets really, really emotional. I had tears in my eyes by the end. Really love how the dynamics keep changing between each character as we get more deep into the story. I think the writing is fabulous. It's very well crafted. You know, there are so many threads. There are multiple stories and all of them are interlinked and connected throughout like a web. There are twists and turns, but all of them are earned. Nothing feels forced. The ending is very unexpected. In a way, it does throw you off. The whole cast has done an amazing performance and Kate Winslet is leading from the front. So do add this 7-episode show in your watch list. Now I'll be getting into the spoilers. So if you haven't seen the show, stop it. Go watch it and come back. You know, over the years, we have seen a lot of detective shows. But here, you realize that she's a detective in this town. She lives, she knows everyone around and how difficult it makes to do her job. Because no one in the town is stranger to her. She knows them really, really well and how that impacts in solving the case. We see a lot of hardships. All the characters, something or the other is going on with them. They are lying about things. They are hiding things. And as you progress more in the show, we find out about all of those things. The big theme of the show is tackling grief, getting over it. You know how relationships are affected by it, how people are separated from each other by not talking, by suffering alone. And over that, the failure in life. Unable to save his son, unable to save someone else's daughter, unable to solve the case. There is so much depth in each character. No one feels like one tone or one dimensional. At some points, it feels like there's so much happening to in their life. Oh my God, give them a break. I didn't know anything about the show, didn't watch the trailers at all, nothing. Only knew that Kate Winslet is in this. So I was totally surprised to see Evan Peters in it. The Quicksilver or Ralph Boner from WandaVision. His story didn't end well. Julian Nicholson, who plays Lore, her friend, she was just amazing. And what to say about Kate, man? Oh my God. She's the most attractive granny. I have to say that. No wonder everyone is asking her on a date. I would too. I think she performed amazingly, you know. There was so much going on with that character. It was so nuanced. At no point she's Kate Winslet. She is Mare. And she wonderfully carries the whole show on her shoulders. I did have some issues. In the beginning two episodes, we get to see so many characters. But in later episodes, suddenly they are just gone. None of them is mentioned. Suddenly it feels like they don't even exist. But in later episodes, they come back. So it feels like though they didn't have anything to show for them. Or maybe they wanted to focus on just this. But it definitely felt, you know, some character was just gone. No one even know about them, not even, you know, in background we see them, not at all. So that definitely felt off. Maybe there were scenes with those characters, but they cut it out for pacing issues, possible. But I did felt their absence in certain places. There were some 2-3 sequences in the later half of the show where I felt, you know, the character actions were very questionable. It didn't really make sense. Why would you do this or that? You know, when Dylan is chasing Erin's friend, and he follows her and, you know, gets a gun and says don't talk to the police, and that was so unnecessary. A lot of times I felt why Erin's friend is not telling the police things, and at the end we get to know the reason, but it's not that clever or that motivating. Oh my God, that's why she was hiding things from the police. But it was nothing that ruined the show or the plot for me. Definitely a great watch. Long episodes, but binged it in a day. It's been a long time since I did that, and now Family Man 2 is coming, so get ready for that. So guys, that is the video. If you like this, hit the thumbs up button, share this video, let me in the comments your thoughts. If you haven't subscribed yet, check out the videos. If you like them too, do subscribing, and I'll see you next time.